She's known as Myrtle Fillmore, the co-founder of Unity along with her husband Charles Fillmore. But she was born Mary Carolyn Page on August 6, 1845, the seventh of nine children. As a child, she adopted the name Myrtle and would later reject the teachings of her strict religious parents. Ever since she was a little girl, Myrtle had been sick. At a young age, she contracted tuberculosis. For many years, she believed she was incurably weak and sickly.
I had all the ills of mind and body that I could bear. Medicine and doctors ceased to give me relief, and I was in despair.
That was until Myrtle discovered new spiritual ideas and principles we now call Unity. The year was 1886, and Myrtle was in her early 40s. She and her husband Charles attended a lecture by metaphysician Dr. E.B. Weeks of Chicago. Myrtle left the talk with a stronger faith and an understanding of her innate divine potential for healing through affirmative prayer.
It flashed upon me that I might talk to the life in every part of my body and have it do just what I wanted. I began to teach my body and got marvelous results.
Instead of seeing her body as weak, inefficient, and diseased, she began speaking words of strength and power to every part of her body, her liver, stomach, abdomen, limbs, eyes, and heart.
I didn't get discouraged at their being slow to wake up, but kept right on, both silently and aloud, declaring words of truth until they did respond. And neither did I forget to tell them that they were free, unlimited spirit. I told them they were the centers of life and energy, omnipresent.
Myrtle began, regularly affirming,
I am a child of God, and therefore I do not inherit sickness.
By repeating this affirmation, Myrtle believed she was going to get better. And 2 years later, she did. In 1888, she was healed of the tuberculosis condition that had threatened her life. Myrtle remained committed to blessing and encouraging her body with true thoughts and words.
I became very watchful as to what I thought and said. I didn't let any worried or anxious thoughts into my mind. And I stopped speaking gossipy, frivolous, petulant, angry words.